time like gambling develop into an addiction that's so tough to break? Joining us now to share her story is Leah Stlichal, who's a recovering compulsive gambler. Leah, thanks so much for joining us this morning.
Thank you for having me.
First off, tell us your story.
I started gambling at age 21 in the casinos, playing keno, scratch tickets. I did all that, and basically, I think the casinos sending me things in the mail.
Enticements, kind of?
Enticements, yes. Okay. Getting to be a platinum gold member just made it more, made me more vulnerable. And I ended up having to go to treatment for my gambling addiction. Mm-hmm. And my family went through treatment along with me. My husband is very supportive. And I've been clean since December of 2008.
Congratulations.
Thank you.
What did it do to you? I mean, how did you know you had a problem? What was starting to happen?
Physically, there were physical changes, not sleeping, not eating. You know, the money situation, we weren't able to pay the bills. So that's how I knew.
Right. And did somebody else notice too, or was it you? Did your husband notice? Anybody else in your family, friends?
Yes, my kids noticed more than my husband because I told them where I would be, you know, not to tell my husband. So my kids noticed.
And let's back up and why did you start gambling? Was it the thrill of it, or were you trying to get rich? I mean, what do you recall?
The thrill. Mm-hmm. I recall one time where my husband and I had gone after a function here in Omaha. We had spent the night, went there, and he was winning, and I was ready to go. Okay. But the enticement of food and winning, the commercials, I think that's what happened, is I just wanted to win something.
And how long would you stay over at the casinos?
Ooh, 12 all day, 12 hours all day. Sometimes, you know, it just depended on if I was by myself or with my husband.
And so you noticed you had a problem when the bills and you had to tell the kids not to tell your husband.
Yes.
How does that make you feel, I mean, knowing that?
I was very sad and devastated that I would even do something like that because I would never have thought of doing something like that, lying to my husband about gambling or anything like that.
Did it catch you by surprise, the addiction?
No, it creeped up on me.
Okay.
There has always been gambling in my family since I can remember. Them talking about going to casinos, we played poker at family functions, you know.
But that seems pretty innocuous. I mean, a lot of people will have weddings they'll go to, and you'll see the guys all around playing pitch or something like that, you know, or you know, hearts or, you know. I mean, that doesn't seem like it would be a gateway to a problem.
Well, when you're introduced to something and, you know, you have something nice as a reward, like we would play for money.
Okay.
So, you know, that's how I got hooked.
Right, little bit by little bit.
Vacations.
Okay, so you've stopped gambling for about 4 years now.
Yes.
That's very good. What did you do to stop? I mean, where did you go to get help? You said you had counseling.
Yes, I went to Choices Treatment.
Okay.
The first thing I did was call that 1-800-BETS-OFF number. They gave me two places to go. Choices was my choice to go to. I had to stay up all night to call them because they didn't have the on-call number. And I went there. Deb consoled me, talked about financials, what I had done. They offered therapy once a week, individualized therapy, group therapy once a week, and counseling once a week. So once I graduated, then, you know, I do contact them once in a while.
What did they, when you say all the counseling and the financial, what did you have to do? I mean, did you have to just start over, put everything out there and say, this is where I am, I have to take my bills and how do I get on a payment plan, that kind of stuff? If someone was watching this, how would you explain it to them?
Well, you go through a 12-step process,
okay.
And that's kind of like AA.
Right.
And then I didn't know what Choices was going to, how they were going to help me. But they helped me with financials. We made payments to places. And I didn't want to file bankruptcy, but we ended up filing bankruptcy. But I tried to make payments and work with Choices and the creditors before that happened.
Tell me about that night that you sat up waiting to make the call. I assume, just tell me, did you back and forth, call, don't call, that kind of thing?
No, I was ready.
You were ready.
I was on the verge of committing suicide.
Really?
Yes.
That is a severe step. I mean, what do you think about that looking back now?
I can't believe I was at that point. I mean, I had called my husband in June from the casino, bawling and asking for his help, but I don't think he knew how to help me. Mm-hmm. And so we went on, and I just decided, that's it. That is it. I'm at my lowest point. I need help.
Finally, then, what would you tell someone watching this today who think they may be on the same road that you were on?
Do not let it get to the point where you feel the way I did. Mm-hmm. If you need help, don't feel ashamed and go get help.
I just have to say, Leah, incredibly strong and brave for coming forward and talking about this. Hopefully it will help somebody.
I hope so, yes.
Great. Thank you, and good luck.
Thank you.